Hey, it's Chris. From strange sounds out of deep space to strange animal behavior, here are 8 unsolved scientific mysteries that we're still trying to figure out. Number 8. What's going on with Kava? Kava is a drink or extract made from a plant called Piper Methysticum, which is native to the Pacific Islands. It is often used as an herbal remedy for anxiety, sleeping problems, and emotional stress, and has a long history of use in alternative medicines and traditional ceremonies by Pacific Islanders. Its euphoric and calming effects have been compared with that of alcohol, and it's a pretty popular social drink. During the 1990s, Kava became popular in the US, Canada, and Europe. Some Kava users in these parts of the world reported in 2001 that they experienced liver problems due to the plant extract. Following this news, Kava was regulated or banned in several Western countries. While Kava remains legal in the US, the Food and Drug Administration recommends consuming it cautiously and in limited doses due to its potential to cause severe liver problems. The Australian Drug Foundation reports that Kava is a depressant and relaxes your muscles. Oddly, the Pacific Islanders who've been using Kava for many years had no known history of suffering from liver problems or other toxic effects from it. There are several theories for why Kava might affect users outside of its native region, including the possibility of genetic differences between Westerners and Pacific Islanders, how the plant is prepared, and the type of Kava that's consumed. Number 7. What is dark matter? The theory of the existence of dark matter was first proposed in 1922 by Dutch astronomer Jacobus Kapteyn. Since then, scientists have determined that dark matter does, in fact, exist. However, we can't see it and we don't know exactly what it is. They learned that dark matter exists mainly based on observing how it interacts with matter that humans can observe. Dark matter does not adhere to the classification of most matter that's visible to us, which is typically made of protons, neutrons, and electrons. It's made up of particles that haven't yet been categorized, and these particles interact with light and matter in ways yet unknown to humans. Scientists know dark matter exists mainly because its gravitational influence bends light as it passes nearby. However, dark matter does not absorb, reflect, or emit light. That's probably how it got its name. Since its inception, scientists have been trying to get to the bottom of this phenomenon. Researchers have come one step closer thanks to the Large Hadron Collider at the European Council of Nuclear Research, or CERN. By accelerating tiny particles and studying the energy and momentum involved when they collide at high speeds, scientists hope to identify the invisible material known as dark matter. Despite this advancement, as well as the recently proposed possibility of seeing dark matter via the use of gravitational wave detectors, science has a long way to go before the mysteries surrounding dark matter are fully solved. Number 6. The causes and cures of putrid finger. Putrid finger is exactly what it sounds like. This stinky condition first drew widespread attention in a 1996 Lancet article, which described an unnamed Welsh man who had cut his finger on a chicken bone in 1991. At some point after getting the injury, the 29-year-old man showed up at the emergency room at Gwent Hospital in Newport, Wales. His finger was red and it reeked like rotten meat. During his visit, the man consulted with 4 different doctors, and the doctors attempted to treat the condition with all kinds of antibiotics, but to no avail. After the antibiotics failed, they had no choice but to resort to an invasive procedure. No soft tissue damage, pus, or foreign body damage were discovered upon surgical exploration of the smelly appendage. The man's finger carried a distinct odor for 5 years. Throughout that time, doctors tried every solution they could think of, including UV light treatment, antibiotic withdrawal, sorolins, Culperman, and more. They pushed the Lancet article in hopes of finding other physicians who had encountered the same strange affliction. Definitive answers were never found, however, and fortunately for the patient, the smell eventually disappeared. Number 5. Fast radio bursts from deep space. In early September 2017, 15 blasts of radio waves hurled through space. The episode was heard by astronomers, who described the blasts as fleeting but extremely powerful. The source of the burst was a galaxy roughly 3 billion light years away, and dozens of times smaller than the Milky Way. Scientists with the Breakthrough Listen Project had aimed the Green Bank Telescope in West Virginia to a location in the sky where a previous burst of radio waves, known as FRB121102, had been heard. These types of waves were detected for the first time in 2007. Around 24 of these bursts have been observed, but FRB121102 is the only one known to repeat. And because of that, it's the only set of waves with an established home galaxy. Energetic blasts such as these occasionally come from places with strong magnetic fields, but scientists aren't sure what causes them. One largely favored theory is that the bursts represent collisions between or explosions near extremely dense objects. Some believe that the bursts are a form of signal or communication from advanced intelligence. In other words, maybe aliens. But what do you think causes these blasts? How about you let me know in the comments below? Number 4. Dozens of octopuses exit the sea. It's not unusual for an octopus to march onto land every now and then, usually to cross from one tide pool to another. But in late 2017, over 24 octopuses were seen walking on land in Wales. The event even baffled one lifelong local, Brent Stones, who had never seen anything like it. None of the octopuses seemed injured or showed other signs of harm. Stones and others helped to return them to the deep waters, and as soon as they landed into the sea, they seemed fine. Over the next few nights, however, Stones returned to the beach and observed several dead octopuses. National Geographic reached out to experts who proposed three possible theories. The first one proposed that the octopuses had gone senile. With a lifespan of just 1 year, they usually die shortly after laying eggs, which they typically do in October. This theory fits within the timeline of the event. But it's also possible that the octopuses had been displaced from the water by two recent major storms, named Brian and Hurricane Ophelia. Other experts pointed to a 2016 study in Current Biology, which found that octopuses were probably being forced to travel further than usual for food and shelter due to a booming population. The large-scale visits by octopuses to the beach stopped around mid-November. Number 3. Why humans can't walk in a straight line. In 2009, a German research scientist named Jan Sohmann co-wrote a paper about an experiment that showed that humans are actually incapable of walking in a straight line. The subjects of the experiment were blindfolded and told to walk in a straight line for up to an hour, but instead, they actually walked in circles. The experiment was conducted in various settings, including the Sahara Desert and the beach, and the results were the same every time. Sohmann then conducted the same experiment, but without blindfolds. When it was cloudy outside and visibility was low, the volunteers walked in circles. In sunny, hospitable weather, one test subject was able to walk a relatively straight and steady line. One conclusion to the experiment is that humans rely on external focal points to walk straight. What scientists haven't figured out is why. According to Sohmann, there's no single explanation for why we tend to walk in circles. He's currently working on a multi-causal theory. So if you get lost in the woods, be careful to look for markers because you will most likely be walking in circles for days. Number 2. No changes in genomes. For millions of years, hundreds of small segments of the human genome, as well as those in other animals, have remained unchanged. Harvard professor Ting Wu and her colleagues are trying to understand why. These small genome segments are called ultra-conserved elements, or UCEs. One theory for why they've remained unchanged for millions of years is because they carry out life-sustaining functions. Some studies have shown that UCEs have no purpose, and they don't even play a role in the production of protein like most strands of DNA. Scientists removed the UCEs from mice in one experiment. If UCEs are essential to life-sustaining functions, this meant the mice should have died, but they didn't. In fact, they were completely healthy. Professor Wu believes that UCEs act as surveillance by scanning individual cells for errors. Her theory is called surveillance hypothesis. According to the theory, a cell with many errors would be killed or commanded to exterminate itself. However, even Wu herself admits that this theory is inconclusive. Number 1. Why humans enjoy music. There's no scientific explanation for why humans have a natural inclination towards music, but it would be difficult and depressing for most of us to imagine a world without it. And if our brains have a music center, well, scientists haven't discovered it yet. They do know that comprehending and processing music is a high-order process involving multiple parts of the brain. When a person focuses on the harmony of a song, for example, their right temporal lobe activates. The right temporal lobe works closely with the frontal lobe to form meaningful music syntax. In a 2001 study conducted by McGill College, researchers determined that when someone hears a song that gives them goosebumps, a certain part of their brain lights up, the same part of the brain that's associated with other pleasurable activities, such as sex. This simulation is associated with a few mechanisms that are related to survival, leading scientists to believe that humans may have been conferred an evolutionary advantage of some sort by being able to understand and appreciate music. Well, there you go. Would you like to learn more about unsolved scientific mysteries? Let me know in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.